गुड मॉर्निंग फ्रेंड्स, गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल। टुडे वी टॉपिक आवर टॉपिक इज पल्स कोड मॉड्यूलेशन। ओके, कमिंग टू द पल्स कोड मॉड्यूलेशन, द प्रोसेस ऑफ सैम्पलिंग विच वी हैव ऑलरेडी डिस्कस्ड इन द इनिशियल स्लाइड्स। हियर we have mainly two types of modulation techniques which will be converting the analog to the digital conversion. So the pulse code modulation and delta modulation, these two techniques which will be used for the basic techniques of the digital modulation techniques. Okay, digital modulation techniques. So coming to the pulse code modulation, the pulse code modulation is most commonly used in the digital modulation screens. This is the basic simple modulation technique which will be used in the digital communications. So in PCM, the available range of the signal voltage is divided into the levels, and each level assigned as a binary number, that will be 0 or 1, that will be assigned whenever the signal will be divided. Okay, each sample is represented by a binary number and transmitted serially. The whatever the signal that will be divided, that signal will be, each sample will be represented some binary number, and that will be transmitted serially. Okay, serially means one by one. Okay, so the number of levels available depends upon the number of bits used to express the sample value. Okay, so the number of levels which will be given as a representation of capital N, so that is equal to 2 power m, that is the representation of the number of levels. And coming to the pulse code modulation, here coming to the pulse code modulation, they will be obtained three parts, mainly sampling and quantization and binary encoder. This is the only in the transmitting part. Okay, the pulse code modulation which is related to the transmitting part. So before we sample, we have to use filter which is a low pass filter. So it will be limits the higher components, only allows the lower components of the frequencies. So the filter should ensure that we do not disturb the signal, so remove the higher frequency component that affects the signal shape. So we can use the low pass filter in front of the sampler to remove the higher frequency components. This is the block diagram. Here first part which is related to the transmitting section of the pulse code modulation, and second part is the transmission channel path, and third part is the receiver part of the pulse code modulation. Here you can see the source continuous signal that will be given to the low pass filter. So low pass filter which will be allows the low frequency component and doesn't allows the high frequency component, which will be affects the shape of the original signal. So the low pass signal will be given to the sampler, and sampler which will be samples, the number of samples it will be divided, and that will be given to the quantizer. Here whenever it will be sampling, there it will be whenever it will be samples, then it will be convert the low pass analog signal into the number of samples. So the samples are discrete time in nature, but the amplitude will be continuous, that is the representative of the sampler, and that signal will be given to the quantizer which will be quantize the signal. Continuous sample amplitude will be converted into the discrete sample amplitude. So the main functionality of the encoder, which will be converts the quantizer output into the binary form. This is the transmitting part, and that will be given to the regenerated repeaters. Wherever the signal drop will be obtained, there you can use the regenerator repeaters to boost up the signaling strength, and that will be given to the regenerated circuit. And regenerated circuit reconstruct the original signal and produces the noiseless PCM signal and produces the noiseless PCM signal that will be given to the decoder, and decoder which will be converts the binary form to the continuous signal form. Okay, decoder which will be converts the binary form into the discrete form of the signal, and that signal, discrete form of signal, that will be given to the reconstructed filter. And reconstructed filter, the main functionality of the reconstructed filter is to produce the reproduces the original input signal. This is the main blocks of the pulse core modulation. Okay, and we can see one by one here what is the functionality of the sampler. The main functionality of the sampler is to convert the low pass output into the number of samples, okay. And these samples are discrete time in nature, but amplitude of the samples continuous in nature. Okay, only whatever the number of samples that will be divided, always they will be in discrete in time, but the amplitudes will be continuous. Okay, and here the sampling frequency always greater than the twice of the frequency of the message signal. That is the condition for the sampling. So it will be satisfies the Nyquist condition, fs greater than 2 fm. Always this condition will be satisfied, then only it will becomes under the sampling. Okay, and the sampler output will be given to the quantizer. And the quantizer, what is the main functionality of the quantizer will be here. The quantizer process divides the maximum value of the analog signal into the number of levels order that will be converted into the binary code. So the main functionality of the encoder, so the quantizer output will be given to the encoder. Then the main functionality of the encoder is to convert the quantizer output into the binary form, that means zeros and ones. Okay, and it also performs the parallel transmission into serial transmission. Whatever the quantizer output that will be obtained, that signal will be given to the encoder. It will be converts the discrete amplitude sample output will be converted into the binary form. And not only it will be converting the binary form, it will be also be converted parallel transmission signal to the serial transmission signal, that means at a time signal to the single transmission bit. Okay, and coming to the receiver section of the pulse code modulation, here we have see the already receiver section. We have regenerated circuits, decoders, and reconstructed filters. Finally, we have destination. So the output of the regenerative repeaters output will be given to the regenerative circuits. So here noise will be added. So the main functionality of the regenerator circuit is to produce noiseless PCM, noiseless pulse code modulation signal. So it will be given to the demodulator. The main functionality of the demodulator is convert the binary form into discrete form of the signal, and it also performs serial transmission into parallel transmission, and that signal will be given to the reconstructed filter. Okay, whatever the signal, decoder signal, that will be functions the binary form into discrete form of the signal, and it will be also be a functions the operation of serial transmission to the parallel transmission, and that signal will be given to the reconstructed filter. And the main functionality of the reconstruction filter is to reproduces the input signal or original signal. Whatever the original signal you will be given input, that signal will be reconstructed. To produce the reproduces the original signal. Okay, this is the basic receiving section of the pulse code modulation. Under we have regenerate to repeaters in between the transmitting and receiver in the channel. So the main functionality of the regenerate to repeaters is to increase the signaling strength of the PCM signal. Wherever the signal will be traveling from for a distance, then the signal will be dropping the signaling strength whenever it will be traveling for a long distance. Wherever it will be dropping, there you can use the regenerated circuit to increase the signal strength of the PCM signal. So it performs mainly three operations in the regenerated repeaters. So one is equalization, and another is timing of circuit and decision making. So here equalization, which will be used for the amplifier equalization. So whatever the input signal, PCM signal, will be taken, and that will be amplifies to the original signal to boost up the signal. And the decision making device will be used here, and the decision making device, which will be takes the decision original signal amplitude is came or not. So based on that, regenerative repeaters will be functioned. Okay, here you can see the how the sampling and quantization will be done here. So number of levels, how the sample so will be divided into the number of levels will be taken into the count. Here you can see first waveform, which will be represents the continuous sinusoidal signal. So that sinusoidal signal, input signal, which will be having the continuous time and amplitude signal, that will be given to the sampler. Sampler functionality is, it will be divided into the number of samples, which will be giving the some number of levels. So here the second signal, which will be gives the number of samples signal, and after there the discontinuous in time, and the amplitude will be continuous. So that sample signal will be given to the quantization, then quantization, which will be converts the discrete amplitude signal to binary form. So you can see in last diagram, which will be given that 0101 representation, that will be tells about the binary form of the original signal of the quantization output, that is the waveform here. And you can see some digital representation of the pulse code modulation transmitter. So here some of the waveforms which will be related, how the signal will be initiated, how the signal will be taken into the one by one blocks. Okay, first you will see analog signal will be given, and that will be a low pass signal. So low pass filter will be eliminates the higher frequencies, only required signal will be transmitted. And here sampled the signals and PAM signal will be obtained here. After the sampling, only continuous discrete amplitude will be obtained. Continuous amplitude will be obtained, discrete time signal will be obtained. So there is a no continuous in the time, and amplitude is continuous. So that signal will be given to the quantizer, and quantizer, which will be quantize the signal, and there will be discrete pulses will be obtained. Discrete signal will be obtained. That signal, discrete signal, will be given to the encoder. So encoder, which will be converts the discrete signal to the binary form. So it will be converted into the one zeros. Binary form means zeros and ones. And here another important is parallel transmission will be converted into the serial transmission by using the encoder. So here also 1010, one by one the sequence number will be obtained. Binary sequence will be obtained here. Okay, this is the pulse code modulation.